Coach Villarrial, this is going into my third year at St. Francis University. My background is went to IUP, then was drafted in the fifth round, and had 12 long seasons in the NFL. It was a great time. Ended up here at St. Francis. Started here as the offensive coordinator, and now we're trying to rebuild this program and build it to where it needs to be, to a championship program. And this will be our third class bringing in. We're very happy with the class that we have in. We brought in a lot of speed. We increased our team speed overall. We brought in a lot of physical guys. So our physicalness is up. And we brought in a lot of high caliber classroom guys, so that grade wise, academically, these guys are going to be able to graduate and go on in the future. So we're extremely happy. We filled a lot of voids that we needed. Running back position, we have two senior running backs, so we had to bring in some running backs to fill the void. We got 2 6-2 receivers. We brought in some big offensive linemen, and in our secondary, we brought in a lot of depth, and possibly two young rookies that could come in and start for us. We're very excited about it, and looking forward to the challenge this year. Basically, Josh Steele is a guy that has come in and built himself into a great kicker. Our kicking coach has worked with him tremendously, Coach Joe Shook. But he's just a very guy that we see. He's got veins of ice. He came out here and we had 18 inches of snow and kicked and tied the school record for a 45-yard field goal. And then the following week he went out and kicked a 47-yarder versus Mama. So he's just a guy that's come in and developed himself. He's worked hard in the weight room. He's down in the field every day practicing different things and just doing what it takes to become a great kicker. Not only does he practice kicking every day, but he's also practices tackling every day. So he's just a tremendous attribute to us. Anthony Bowman, he's a Maryland prospect at a good council. Had a great year for us. Made a lot of tackles. Very instinctive football player. He's worked very hard this offseason. And we're looking for big things out of Anthony. He just comes in with a tremendous work ethic. He comes in highly conditioned every year. Just has a good football background. And obviously, Kyle Harbridge is the guy that has really helped put us on the map. Kyle is the guy that came in pretty much as a guy that not many teams were looking at. He's come in, built himself into the player he is. He's one of the premier running backs in the country. And then I think Kyle stays healthy. Kyle has a bright future ahead of him and possibly a chance to play at the next level. But, we just want to keep him healthy and keep him going. But, he's just a good all-around kid, holding a GPA of a 3.6. So, Kyle's really come in and done really well for himself. Basically, with my background as being an offensive lineman in the NFL, we love to run the ball. So, we're going to be a run first, pass second. We just want a nasty mentality. We want a mentality that we're not going to lose, that we're just going to try to wear you out and pound the ball down your throat and at the end of the day, come out on top score-wise. So we're a very multiple offensive formation. We run a little pistol, a little spread, little zone concept, power counter. So we're very multiple, and I think the type of lineman that we bring in here really helps helps us block these multiple formations and with the agility they have. So this is something that we're just going to keep building on and each year getting better at, and I think that we could have a very good solid offense for years to come. When I was in Chicago, one of the biggest things I learned was I was with Tony Wise. Dave Wonstadt was the coach at the time. Tony Wise is a big power O guy, and he taught me how to to use leverage, taught me how to use my hands, and taught me to be an overall more aggressive player. He just did a tremendous job. And then, you know, Coach Bob Wiley came in. He was a big zone guy, and he taught me how to be a more balanced offensive lineman. So, you know, working with these two guys was just great. And then I went into Buffalo working with one of the Hall of Fame coaches, and Coach Jim McNally, who's the guru of offensive line. And, you know, working with him and the perfection he demands as an offensive line coach was just tremendous for me. Overall balance and how to use your hands, how to keep your head out of the block, keeping a base at all times, you know, learning how to use the duck demeanor. These guys just taught me tremendous work ethic and what it takes to be a great professional. And obviously these are some of the attributes that I brought with me to hand down to these guys and try to show them that, you know, if you want to be the best, this is what it takes. And, you know, it's going to take us some time, but I feel very confident that we are going to turn this program around and get it going in the right direction. There's quite a few of them, but the one that always sticks out in my mind, and I don't know if a lot of people know who John Randall was. John Randall is a Hall of Fame defensive tackle for the Minnesota Vikings, but I'll never forget the one day we were up there playing in the Dome, and they were beating up on us pretty good, and John split me and Big Cat and made a sack. And I remember I was going down to pick up our quarterback at the time, who was Eric Kramer, and I remember John sitting there on top of him, and I don't know if you guys remember the old Snickers commercial, you know, you're going to be here a while, might as well grab a Snickers, and John just blurted that out, you know, just said, hey Eric, and Eric looked up at him, and he says, hey Eric, you're going to be here, you're going to be down here for a while, so you might as well grab a Snickers. And it was just, even though it was a bad play, it's just something that I was in my young career, it just always stood out in my mind, and it was just one of the things that you had to been there to see it, but it was an unfortunate play, but it's a memory that's lasted with me a lifetime, and we tried to make sure that Eric wasn't grabbing too many Snickers then later, so, but, you know, that was one of the premier funny things, I guess, that's happened in my career. Mm-hmm. You know, just growing up, you know, my parents were always the parents that were on the block and said, anything you start, you must finish. And, you know, I made the unfortunate thing of one time in my young life of joining the choir. And, chorus, I guess you should say, and I wanted to quit the second day I was in it because, as you can tell, my voice is not much of a singing voice. But, you know, I finished it out, and you know, that just installed the work ethic. I mean, my parents installed it. Always big supporters. My grandparents were big supporters, and it was just something through my whole career that I always looked up to all these guys, and one of the guys I always looked up to was, you know, Ed Tuttle Jones and Mark Gastineau, and these guys were the guys I always looked up to, and I always wanted to be like, and I had an opportunity as a young man to go watch the Washington Redskins when they used to practice at Dickinson College, and I got to meet Dexter Manley at the time he was playing for Washington, and that just stuck with me, and I always wanted to be a professional football player, and you know, I had a lot of trials and tribulations. I had good people around me. My coaches were great people. Coach Gump May always pushed me in the right direction, and it was just a work ethic they installed in me that you know, you gotta live in the weight room and you gotta practice every day and go through your plays in your mind every day. And it was something that I did, and it paid off in the long run. Obviously, I went about it, you know, the tough route. You know, I went to IUP and got drafted to IUP, but I wouldn't change it for the world because it's taught me a lot of life skills, and I'm proud of who I am today. I'm proud of my parents, and you know, I thank them every day for giving me that work ethic, and it's paid off. You know, obviously, I'm a guy that likes to hunt and fish, but one of the big things that I've gotten into is horse pulling, and I've got some big 2,500 pound horses out of my farm, and I've gotten into competitive horse pulling, and it's something that we're learning at it, we're getting better at it, but you know, just working with these big horses who you know, I call just natural big offensive linemen athletes, or it's just something that we picked up and we've gotten into, and you know, we've traveled up and down the East Coast, and you know, we're doing pretty well at it, and we have some great people that help us. You know, Billy Howard and these guys help us a lot, and it's just something that we picked up that it kind of takes my mind off all the stresses, and you know, I can get out there and just be with them horses, and it takes you away from football for a while, and but you're also doing something great and watching athletes do something else great. So you know, it's something that gets me away from the office for a while. So, you know, coming in here, a lot of our guys really didn't know how to prepare. So it's something that we've kind of brought in and are teaching our guys how to prepare for a game. But I'm not a rah-rah guy by no means. I'm not a guy that's going to sit there and give rah-rah speeches. You know, I'm kind of cut and dry when it comes to it. And it's something that I've learned from you know, my coaches and my mentors over the years. You know, we do have them coaches that you know, try to get everyone fired up. Obviously, you need that in a locker room setting. But I'm the guy that just tries to tell these guys, you know, go out, give everything you got, and that's, you know, that's all we can ask of you. You know, if you mess up, have a short term memory, forget about it, and let's move on to the next play, and let's get a victory the next play. So, you know, I just try to bring more sensibility to the locker room and just try to encourage them. I'm a big encourage guy. I encourage my staff to do the same. I don't like to be a screamer and yeller, but obviously sometimes you have to do it. But, you know, I'm more of just a guy that likes to encourage and keep the locker room, keep these guys calm and relaxed before the game, because obviously when the gun starts, you know, they got to be ready to go. Obviously, you know, your goal is always to have a winning season. I think any coach in this profession is going to tell you, you know, your first and foremost goal is to have a winning season. Obviously, you know, it could be very easy for me to sit here and say, listen, we want to get to the playoffs, we want to do this. But I think first and foremost, we have to learn how to win, and we have to win. We have to learn how to win on the road. We haven't won on the road here in, I think, 4 or 5 years or something like that. So we got to learn how to win. We got to learn how to win football games, and we got to put together this year. My expectations are to do that this year. And, you know, my expectations is to try to have the number one offense in the NEC and have number one defense. Will we achieve that? We don't know. But first and foremost, we have to learn how to win. And that's my goal for this team this season. And we can start this. We can get these wheels turning here and get this program upright and sailing in the right direction. Yes. Hi, my name is Coach Villarrial. I am the head football coach at St. Francis University. I'd like to give high praise to the three players I've been talking about, and Mr. Bowman, Josh Steele, Kyle Harbridge. Keep working hard, guys. We need you to have a big season for us. And to all the St. Francis fans out there, stick with us. Keep backing us. We always appreciate your support. And this thing's going to turn around for you. And look forward to seeing you guys in the stands.